Yes, I'm in Sydney, Australia, where a lot of the film was made. Now, if you take a look behind me, lots of people starting to gather, and very soon some very important guests, including celebrities, are going to be walking the leafy carpet for the Australian premiere.
Hi, how's it going? Charlie from What Now?
Yeah.
Magic, thank you very much.
Media, that's us.
Now, these premieres have the reputation of putting on some huge exhibitions, and today, luckily, we get a sneak peek, so let's go. Premieres aren't just about seeing the film, but also learning about how they are made. And the crack team of visual effects wizards that worked on Legend of the Guardians have been brought in today to recreate the world of Gahul for us. Now, guys, I'm here with Grant Freckleton, who is actually one of the art directors for the film. Now, Grant, what does an art director do?
Well, in an animated film, basically nothing exists at the beginning of the process, and we have to create everything. So it's part of my job and part of the job of a team of amazing artists here at Animal Logic to actually think up all of the things that are going to be in the film. So we have to think up what these owls are going to look like, what this world of Gahul is going to look like.
To bring the different characters to life, the artists spent hours at the Sydney Zoo looking at real owls and copying their every move before recreating them almost precisely on screen. Now, Grant, I know there's plenty of kids out there who really, really want to get into making movies just like you. What would be one piece of advice for me?
If you want to be an art director, go out and draw. Draw from your imagination and draw from reality as well, because, you know, you can't actually imagine things unless you observe the world around you. So that's my word of advice if you want to be an art director.
Of course, all the graphics aside, this is a film premiere, and hopefully, because there's lots of glitz and glamour and celebrities, I better keep my eyes peeled, might see some stars. Legend of the Guardians had a stellar cast that worked hard behind the scenes. The film stars Jim Sturgess, Helen Mirren, Hugo Weaving, and even our very own Kiwi, Sam Neill and Emily Barclay. But the biggest star of the film has to be legendary actor Jeffrey Rush.
Well done holding your own in there, good, strong gizzards.
The superstar won an Oscar for the movie Shine, and you may have seen him as the arch-villain Barbossa in Pirates of the Caribbean, and also as Nigel the Pelican in Finding Nemo. And the photographers are out because he's supposed to be here tonight.
I'm a little bit nervous.
Oh, check it out. The guests have arrived. Got to get ready to do my interview. Wish me luck. Now, what I want to know is, why did you guys decide to take on this story and make it into a feature film?
Well, you know, you've got to have a great story to begin with. And Catherine Lasky's books, The Guardians of Gahul, are an amazing series of books. There's 15 of them. Fundamentally, we loved the characters, we loved the world they were in, and we felt we could do something really special with them.
You know, owls are known for wisdom and big eyes, and there's all those little faces and different beaks and big eyes and telling a story. And, you know, I think it'll have an enormous appeal.
My character is forced to do a lot of flying, and which is very hard for an owl who doesn't like flying. He's a burrowing owl and he spends all his time on the ground. So to fly a very long distance required a huge amount of physical energy. Therefore, the sound people forever were trying to tell me to, come on, more energy, more energy, more energy. So, I got very fit doing that.
Okay, now Jeffrey Rush is just over there, and I don't know if he's doing any more interviews, but I'm going to try. Okay. Well, I waited, and I waited. Well, everyone got their photo with Jeffrey Rush, and everyone got their interviews as well. Waited some more, and things weren't looking too good for Charlie P, but just when I thought all hope was lost, I happened to run into him on the way into the film. In real life, you're such an amazing person on the stage and the screen. How was it going into a voice booth and like having to sort of bounce off pretty much nothing?
It's a very lonely experience.
You can't fight them. You have to feel them with your kisses.
So you go in and you put down all your voice tracks, and sometimes you put down alternative readings of lines, and they use you while they've got you, because you can imagine with a cast this size, getting everyone into one room would be a logistical nightmare, so they grab everyone when they can. So I'm really keen to see the film tonight, which I haven't seen, just to see who plays what.
So that all makes sense.
Whether I recognise who they are.
Well, it was such a pleasure talking to you, my friend.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, and I hope you enjoy the movie. I'm sure you will.
New Zealand.
Well, I got to talk to some of the stars from the movie, including Jeffrey Rush. See, I got that in there. Now, of course, we are all here for one reason, and that is to watch this amazing movie. Now, I'm running a little bit late, so I hope they save my seat for me. See you soon.